Hi, my name's Lisa Herzog. I'm in the Paleontology Research Lab here at the museum. And in front of me, laid out, I have a femur of a fossil theropod dinosaur known as Acrocanthosaurus. Acrocanthosaurus is one of our most famous specimens that is on display and mounted in the museum. However, we had to take the original bones off display so that we could preserve them. This fossil has something known as pyrite disease or pyrite decay, which can be very detrimental for a specimen if it's not stored in a controlled environment. Exposure to oxygen in the atmosphere and moisture in the atmosphere can cause the pyrite to decay the specimen. So we've taken it off display and it's safely stored in cabinetry downstairs. Now that the specimen's off display, one of the things we are doing with it is conducting additional research on the specimen to help with the body of research on this particular animal. The process we're doing is called creating a histological slide, or it's also known as histology, which means that we're going to be looking at the specimen on a microscopic level in cross-section. So what we have to do for that is cut the specimen in half. Before we go through this whole process, we consult with other members of the department to make sure that this is a worthwhile venture, because it is a destructive process. So I've already gone through the first step of this process. I cut the bone in half and then I cut a section out of it. And here's what it looks like now. After this section was cut out, this little slice, I embedded it in a clear epoxy resin for stability. I'm gonna be polishing this real smooth and gluing it down to a slide. And then we're gonna polish it even more so it's very, very thin and transparent, and we can look at it with light transmitting through the slide on a microscope, and we can actually see the cellular structure of the bone. One of the things that this can tell us is how an animal grew, if there's any sort of pathologies, meaning if it had any kind of diseases, it'll show up in its bone, and it'll help us understand how old this animal might have been when it died. Was it really, really old? Was it a teenager? Was it still growing? We can tell that by looking at the specimen in this way. This is actually a pretty common method in paleontology, especially for this type of dinosaur. So one of the things we're planning on doing with the dueling dinosaurs is processing the tyrannosaur in this way so that it'll help us understand that animal even better. And we're looking forward to doing that process and conducting the research to help us understand those animals a lot better as well.